That's right, we're doing a packing video. So I'm gonna show you guys what I pack for a month-long backpacking trip. Now, what I pack for a month-long backpacking travel trip is the same thing I'd pack for 2 months, 3 months, or more, as I would just do laundry, so it's applicable for all those situations. We're gonna go through everything here, and I'm gonna show you how I pack it, plus why I pack it. So let's get started. Because on this trip, I have to pack for two different situations. One is heavy-duty outdoor trekking, mountains, camping. The second is regular city travel, day travel, night travel, sightseeing. So two very different kind of clothing and gear requirements. So first I'm gonna do the trekking, then I'm gonna do the typical travel city stuff. Travel backpack, this is one of the most important purchases that we are going to purchase on our backpacking trip because it's where we're gonna keep everything and it's what's gonna hold on our back. So this is the bag I'm taking with me. It is the Farpoint 70, meaning that it carries 70 liters of stuff in it. Now normally this bag has a day bag that attaches on like this, which is fantastic, but I don't use it because I use a specific camera day bag. Bag cover. This is a bag cover that basically makes this backpack waterproof because when it rains, you don't want your stuff to get wet. Next thing is an umbrella because I don't want to get wet when I'm carrying all my gear. Security. Security is important. So I carry two locks with me so I can lock up my main bag and so I can lock my bag up to something using this. So this is a pack safe and it is basically a wired cord. So I can take this and I can wrap this along my bag and wrap it on and attach it to a certain item. And that basically secures my bag to a stationary item if I have to ever leave this unattended for any period of time. Heavy duty nylon rope. So for emergency situations, if I ever need rope. This is my water bottle that I pack with me. This is called Life Straw. Now, the reason why is if you look there, you actually see there is a filter in this. Now, I am going on a camping trip. I'm going to be going into the wilderness and there will be many times where I will need to drink from a stream or a unknown water source. This filters 99% of all the bacteria and it filters out all the mud and all that jazz, so I get nice, fresh, clean water. Now, don't bring normal towels when you go backpacking. You need to bring microfiber or pack towels, basically tinier, more compact, more dryable towels. So these kind of look like this and you see it opens up and it kind of looks like a regular towel. It's a bit lighter though, thinner material. And basically this just dries a lot quicker than a traditional towel. This one is a face one that I use. So this one is actually an antimicrobial towel, meaning that it helps prevent the buildup of bacteria. So I use this one for my face. Now I have some just general purpose stuff sacks. These are great for trying to keep everything organized. Next, I have a laundry bag. Now this is just a mesh bag that I can use to do my laundry because I will be doing laundry many times and you will be doing laundry. That is the key to packing smart, is learning how to do laundry and learning where the laundromats are. You always wanna know when there's a laundromat so you can do laundry. This is, of course, the laundry powder for that laundry. This is double bagged, and obviously I always use a powder, not a liquid, because liquid is a higher chance of spilling all over my stuff. Now this is tissue, AKA toilet paper, because a lot of times toilet paper is actually a luxury in many countries. So this is a spare pillowcase that I carry with me. This is great for many reasons. One, if I'm in a hostel that's really dirty, I can use my own pillowcase. Two, if I need to make a makeshift pillow, I can just stuff a bunch of clothes in there. Now this is a money belt. I'm kind of indifferent to it. Because I am camping and I am sleeping with my stuff, I wanna keep a money belt with me just in case. Now a hair dryer is a bit of a luxury item. I also have a portable hair straightener. It's about this big, but unfortunately it's in the mail. Now, whenever you're doing any type of backpacking trip, you have to kind of think about where you're going and really plan and pack accordingly. Now, on this specific trip, I am actually gonna be in 30 degree heat in South America, and I'm also gonna be in alpine conditions in Patagonia. So I have a mixture of sunny summer heat and as well as alpine cold 0 degree weather. So I have to pack a mixture of everything to be prepared. Rain jacket, we need a good solid rain jacket. Now this is a lightweight, it's a shell. I always bring just a shell on me and then I can do layers underneath. Now this is a Gore-Tex shell, so it's super heavy duty, waterproof, because if you're out there for a couple hours in the rain, you need something super heavy duty waterproof. It also has air vents underneath your arms so you can breathe when you are hiking. This is so important. If you get sweaty like me when wearing a rain jacket and hiking, it's a not a great combination. You might not need some of this winter gear if you are not doing any kind of alpine hiking. That's where you have to kind of pick and plan your trip and what you're packing accordingly. If it's raining or if it's windy and if it's cold, my hands are out and they're exposed for long periods of time. I wanna make sure they're covered. So I have a pair of gloves. So these are waterproof gloves. They're pretty flexible so I can kind of use all the controls of the camera and they will keep my hands nice and toasty and warm. So this is a fantastic all around item that you can pack for any weather. It is a buff. Now a buff basically goes many different ways. It can do a lot of different things. It can go around your neck. It can go around your head. It can go around your ears. It can go around your wrist. So one of the materials that I'm gonna talk about a lot, and you're gonna see a lot, is something called the Mariana wool. Now Mariana is a type of wool. It's super well known. It's from New Zealand and it's well known to be super wicking and warm. And next up, I also have a toque or a beanie, as some people like to call it with me, because again, alpine conditions, cold. I have a scarf. Now this is great for all around everything. You can use a scarf for a lot of different things. You can use it as a blanket or just to keep your neck warm. So all of these items here are meant to be kind of mismatched and layered. So first off, we have my Mariana wool icebreaker vest. This is a super warm vest that is great for when I'm doing exercise, and it's great to just keep the body heat in my core. Next up, I have, these are kind of like my undergarments. This is Mariana wool that I can put underneath my layers to keep me warm. Long johns, long john leggings, which are Mariana wool as well, and that keeps me warm. Now this is a specific like sportsy outdoor like as well. So it's meant to keep me warm when I wanna be warm and keep me cool and dry when I wanna be cool and dry. Now, for when I'm not doing exercise and outdoorsy stuff, I want to have a nice long sleeve shirt. So I have this is just like a simple sweater. You always wanna have something that's a little bit nicer as a long sleeve for if you go out at night for dinners, if it gets a bit cooler. And put that on. Socks, so I have two specific hiking socks and then another Mariana wool, more of like a comforting, warm, could be hiking, but also just comforting, warm sock. Now I have two bags with me. I'm bringing my backpack, day bag, and I also bring a purse. I always bring a purse with me on my travels, and it's something that I can kind of squish down and take out with me. So say if I'm going out at night and I don't want to bring my huge day bag, I still have a small purse. Not because I'm going to South America, I'm doing my Cusco, Peru day purse, but I also have a Harajuku one. This is a fantastic day bag because it's just kind of squishes up like that. I've taken this backpacking with me before. It's fantastic for a day bag. I also have this fake Prada one, which is what I use if I'm like in Europe or something, as a typical like evening purse. Or if you're not big into purses, you can also just bring a clutch. So this is just a small clutch that you can take out if you're not a big purse person. Flip flops, good for hostel bathrooms. I'm bringing hiking boots on this trek because I'm doing a lot of hiking, but normally if I'm not doing hiking, I will bring a pair of running shoes. Next, I have my daytime shoes. So these are my everyday walk around shoes. I always go for Vans. I've literally gone through like six pairs of Vans because they just fit my feet really well and they're great for walking around during the day. These are my luxury shoe. These may or may not make it into my final backpacking. Typically, if I'm doing something where I know I'm gonna be going out to a lot of clubs or something, then I like to bring a wedge or a heel. if I know I'm gonna be going out. Because shoes get dirty, I like to have individual bags for each of my shoes that I bring. Then I have socks, so I'm bringing 6 pairs of socks. I like to keep more of the darker socks because they tend to not look as dirty. So here I have my makeup bag, my first aid kit, and my toiletries. Now, I'm not gonna go through what I put in these because these are actually separate videos, which I'm gonna link down below in the description, or you can click up there. Flashlight, this is a must for any kind of travel. This is a portable fork, knife, and spoon kit. This is brilliant for travel because a lot of times you're eating on the road and you don't necessarily have a fork, spoon, or knife. A Swiss Army knife or utility knife. This has got like pliers, it's got all of those knives. This is a very invaluable tool. Wilderness wipes. This is because I'm doing hiking trips specifically. These are just great to kind of like clean your body off from a day of travel. We've got heavy duty bug spray. Now this is a huge container of bug spray because mosquitoes are literally the worst thing in the entire world. They carry so many diseases with them. So having heavy duty bug spray is pretty important. Also, people always steal this from you as a traveler. If you have bug spray, people are always gonna ask and steal your bug spray. Now this isn't something I typically bring on a backpacking trip, but because I'm going hiking in the Alpine regions, we're camping, there's gonna be a lot of treks, and we're gonna be drinking a lot of different stream water. I need purification tablets. This basically removes all the viruses, extra bacteria, and all that nasty stuff. And this is just filtered that makes the water not taste really gross. Athletic shirts. So I have 2 different athletic shirts here. These are great for working out and any kind of activities. I bring this regardless of the trip that I'm taking. A bathing suit. If I'm going to specifically like a beachier climate where I know there's gonna be a lot more beaches, I would typically bring 2 bathing suits instead of just 1, but I'm not really planning on a lot of beaches on this trip, so just 1 is fine for me. Athletic shorts. These are gonna be my trekking shorts, and I've got 2 sports bras for all of my activities. Now I'm gonna introduce you to the magical beauty of packing called packing cubes. But before I get started on these cubes, which I will show you, this is my underwear cube. So first off, ladies, let me explain to you the beauty of bralettes. Bralettes are amazing for backpackers because they're packable. So if you can, bring bralettes instead of regular bras. It will just make your packing that much easier. In this packing cube here, I've got 3 bralettes and I've got 10 pairs of underwear. Underwear is not something I like to skimp on. I always like to make sure that I have a clean pair of underwear for every day that I'm traveling. So I can usually go 10 days is a good amount of time to go before I will typically need a laundromat. I will aim to do my laundry before 10 days. This is sleepwear. It's just a pair of comfortable shorts and a t-shirt. So my everyday clothes, I'm bringing 2 tank style shirts and 4 t-shirts. These are just regular t-shirts that I'm gonna bring with me. So right now I have 4 pairs of shorts that I'm packing. When I pack all this up, I actually might cut this down to just 3 pairs and I might leave 1 of the jean shorts behind. So I'd like to bring 1 pair of long jeans with me too, so I can like dress up and look nice. And typically normal, like evening time, I like to just wear jeans. This is a vest. I love vests because vests can completely dress up a typical t-shirt and shorts item. I'm sure you've seen this before. This is my long pant romper, as you call it. This is probably one of the most versatile pieces of clothing I've ever come across in my travels. I highly recommend getting yourself a lightweight romper because this is great for hot weather. You can dress it up, so you can wear it out at a club or an event, and you can also dress it down and be casual in it. I wear this thing a lot in the nighttime. So this is just a kind of a 3/4 length dress. Another thing, it's just for evening wear. Don't forget evening wear when you're out backpacking. You can't just have backpacking clothes because you will want to wear something nice sometimes. So having nice clothing, a couple pieces of nice clothing is, you know, very much recommended. All right guys, so now we are in carry-on bag time. Now everything that I'm gonna show you that I put in my carry-on bag. I only carry it in my carry-on bag when I'm in transit. So when I'm traveling to and fro and I have all my stuff packed up. If I'm taking this out on a day trip, I'm not gonna carry all this gear with me. Now this is the bag that I use. I use several different carry-on bags throughout the times, but because I'm going on a more trekking trip, I wanted something with a hip strap and like heavy duty, more of a trekking carry-on photo bag. This is a photo specific bag, meaning that it has a pocket here on the side that has padding for my camera gear. Again, this isn't necessary if you're not bringing a big camera, but I am, so I have a specific camera compartment in my carry-on bag. We've got important documents. We got my passport. So this is a passport case. So in here, I've got my passports and I've got my travel vaccination. Next, I have a notebook to jot down all of my thoughts, etc. A notebook is always really important to have. I got some pens, and then this is all of my documentation required for my trip. Reading material. This is my Spanish in 30 days and Spanish phrase book. I like to have reading material with me. Sometimes I bring a book, but now I'm trying to learn Spanish. Some mints. I like to keep a little bit of hand lotion, a little bit of lip balm, powder because my face gets oily. So then I have all my jewelry with me because I don't like to put that in my check bag. These are just blotting sheets. That is all the rest. So those are my rings. Those are the rest of my jewelry that I'm gonna bring with me. We have my laptop. That's pretty explanatory. Power cords. I always carry my power cords to all my electronics in my carry-on bag in transit. If my main bag gets lost, which it has before, if I have my cords, if I have my plugs, then I could still film, I could still have my computer, everything. I could still use all my electronics. I just don't have clothes usually, which isn't a big deal. Portable hard drive. I like to have one that has, this one is like a, one of those like drop proof thing hard drives because it's got like the squishy ends. I don't really recommend this brand. It's not the best portable hard drive, but something with like protective edges is a good idea. Travel adapters. I usually carry two of these with me on my travels. And in my, again, also in my carry-on because I might need plugs right away. This one's like a crazy multi-country one, depending on where I go. I got a pair of sunglasses here in my case. We got my cell phone, just an iPhone to phone. I have a hat. I will only bring one hat with me and I'm gonna wear that when I'm in transit. Then we've got all of this gear. Now I'm not gonna go through all the specifics of the gear because again, that would make this video too long and that is in a completely different video. So then all that will go into my carry-on bag. I also carry a tripod, a gorilla pod, and this is a grab bag of GoPro accessories in here, and this goes in my big bag as well. So that's it. That is everything I'm gonna pack up with me. Now, let's pack it up. Okay, so packing our main bag. First things first, we're gonna open this up. And I'm gonna put in my tripod since this is the most awkward item. Now, if you don't carry a tripod, then don't worry about this step. I'm gonna try and put the heaviest things kind of, I mean, you wanna kind of aim for the heaviest things in the back and then to the middle back, because that's gonna be closest to your back. Then I'm gonna take my toiletries. I'll take my makeup. Then I've got my GoPro accessories. And then on top, I'm gonna put my first aid kit, as well as my rain cover, because I want those to be super easy to access if I need them. I'll take another packing cube here. Shoes, so these were my Vans, the protective waterproof case. And I'm gonna put my Vans here on the side. I'm gonna take my towel, and then stuff my towel in that corner there. And I'm kind of just gonna do this with the rest of the stuff, kind of mismatch, like figuring out, fitting the, each and every one of the little pieces in. Thank you. And then obviously I have my locks, which I would put on there. And there we go. There we have my entire backpack packed. Now there is little bits of room here and there. Don't forget, I did not forget what I was gonna wear on the plane. So now I put some clothes aside. So when I'm taking a plane, I will always wear my hiking boots. But if I am not taking a plane and I'm just in transit and I don't wanna wear my hiking boots, this is where this carabiner comes in, and I will just clip my hiking boots onto my backpack, open the straps, and strap them in. So they're nice and strapped in, plus they're clipped in from the top. So they'll kind of hang on like that. It's an easier way for me to carry my hiking boots. Carry-on bag packing time. There we go, so we got my main camera in. We got my laptop in. Now I'm gonna kind of fit around everything else. Then I will clip my water bottle onto here and kind of tighten it in there, so it doesn't wiggle around. Be careful that it's not gonna get bashed by the gorilla pod. So it's all screwed in there. Then I will take those, clip them down, and there we go. All that into my carry-on. As option number two, and now this is an option I typically do, and is to have my purse. So while I could fit all the items I needed into my carry-on bag, what I typically like to do is actually carry my purse. If I'm checking my big bag into the airport, I like to carry my small purse. Now, originally, at the beginning of this, I said I was gonna bring this purse, but now I've changed my mind and I'm actually going to bring my Harajuku purse. It's a little bit more flexible and it is bigger. Now, if I was to do option number two, what I would typically do is unload items such as my passport. That'll go in there. I would have maybe my notebook. That would go in there. My phone and my camera, as well as my wallet. Just makes it a little bit nicer. Not as jam-packed to carry. So that is option number two. And the last pile I wanted to direct you to was the did not make it pile, because I'm actually packing as I'm filming this. There were things that just did not make the cut for this packing session. And there we go. There is all the stuff that I'm gonna be taking on my trip. So we got my big bag, we've got my day bag, and we've got my purse. If I carry it, if not, then I'll be put in there. And then this is what I'm gonna wear. So let me quickly change and I'll show you what it looks like on. And there you go. This is the final product. We have my day bag here, turtled up on my body. We have my side bag, if I'm using my side bag. If not, all those compartments, all that stuff would be put into here. And then we got my main bag, just like that. So all nice and turtled up, and that's how I look. Anyways, thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more travel trips. And that's all, okay? Happy travels, bye!